Over there, this is on a villa here, and behind the villa, back over above the trees, is Danguk University. This is the mountain going up beside Danguk University. And if I turn around here, this is a kind of open amphitheater, music classes. They have music classes there in an open amphitheater. And the trail that goes up the mountain starts right there. Okay, so I just walked up from over there. You can see a car is parked here. Sometimes there's a couple of cars here, especially at night. It's kind of a lover's paradise here. And this is the music place. And there's an amphitheater behind it. I'll show you that. Here is the trail up the mountain. You can see the puppies coming down. Okay, you can see the university there above the villas. And you can see that my car is in between the trees down there. And this is the trail. I've just come up with the trail a little bit here. And this is the open amphitheater. I'll show you from the other side. Okay, so here is the amphitheater from the other side. Most people don't see this unless they climb the mountain. You can see the stage. It seats about 600. And then you've got kind of a little grass knoll here that is open to the air for rain. And they put on performances here, rarely actually, but sometimes I've seen, heard them. Never saw anything though. I will continue to go up the trail. Well, you can really see the university there now and some of the traffic inside the university. And you can see this is where the stairs end. Don't like those stairs. And I'm also still pretty close to the amphitheater here. Now, I don't know why exactly, but they've been doing some logging up here, chopping down some trees, maybe the dead ones. Here you can see a big pile of roots from the fallen tree. This would be a pretty good place to put up a tarp and hide next to those roots in an emergency. Push came to shove, it'd be better than nothing. You can see another one here, probably not so helpful. And you can see the trees have been pushed down, or some of them have been sawed off, and they are hanging down into the valley, the little chasm here. And I'll continue to go up the mountain trail. Glad those stairs quit. This is what our trail looks like. And you can see there, they've cut down some trees. Very helpful if I wanted to build a shelter, but I'm too lazy. I'd rather use my tarp. Wow, so much logging here. You can see the brush has all been cut down and are hanging, laying down on the side of the trail. This is all recent. I don't know when they did this cutting, not too terribly long ago. I'm wondering why they do it, actually. Anyways, this is the trail. It goes this way. Okay, now I'm kind of high up here now. I'm just 20 minutes or 15 minutes. I don't know, just it's a short little climb up here. Looking down the trail. And here is a little ridge here. This is where I slept for 2.5 nights under my poncho. It was kind of interesting. First night was quite scary. Every time a leaf would fall from the tree last fall, it was a little nerve-wracking. What was the making the sound? We can go up here. This is where I stayed, right here. I used my poncho and I would string the rope from the tree to the other tree, and the poncho would be in the middle. You can see the road down below. Of course, at night the road's a little more quiet, and the ridge goes way down over there, you can see the trail coming up. And of course, when I was here in the fall, it was still quite secluded. People could walk by without necessarily knowing I was here. But of course, I was at night, nobody knew I was here. And I would leave in the morning quite early. You can see the trail continues up the mountain. We'll go that way in a moment. And so this is where it was, just here. I was here two nights and also half a night. I kind of got a little sick or something, and I needed to go to the restroom, so I left and went back down in the middle of the night, maybe about 2:30 or 3 o'clock in the morning. But the other two nights I stayed all night, and I went back early in the morning. So this was it. It was here. And I would come and arrive here in the night, after dark. And so no one would be coming up and down the trail that would see me. My poncho is bright orange. And that's a reason for that. I could have gotten a blue one. And if I wanted to really hide, I would have gotten the blue one. But in a really, an orange one is easier to see and, you know, be rescued. So I thought orange would be better. So this is it. That's quite a drop off down there. This was it right here. It's kind of flat, a little tilt to it, maybe 2 or 3 degrees, but it was flat enough for me. Kind of hard sleeping on the ground. I don't recommend it. I should have, looking back on it, I should have made a better bed for myself here. Okay, so I'm gonna go over there and continue up the mountain. Okay, I just came up here. I'm tired. Not really in shape. Climbing up the hill here from my sleeping place to here was a little bit of a climb. There's a little bit of a plateau here where I'm standing, and then it really starts going up there. So this is a good place to rest. I don't have any water with me. Stupid idiot. I don't have any water with me, so I'm taking it slow. I don't want to get extremely tired. Also, in my genius, you can see the valley down over on the left. And you can see the university is off in the distance way over there. There's a person coughing in the distance. They're coming down the mountain. I haven't seen too many people so far. Just two. This is the third person coming down. Nobody's coming up catching me. But in my wisdom, I'm wearing my slippers. I'll show you a picture of them later. Okay. Really, it's not a serious climb, but I'm not trying to race up this thing. And I don't want to get too awfully dehydrated or tired. I'm just taking it easy, one step at a time. I'm not resting. It's not strenuous, but just taking it easy. If I just came up there, you can see with this lousy camera, you can see the university in the distance. I'm far above it now. Now this here is the mountain that kind of splits it sticks out into the university. In there you can see the white through the trees is the roof of the stands on their little soccer stadium for the university. And then the university goes around the mountain there and finishes up over there. Now I've gone down this trail here, and it ends up right next to the dormitories of the university. But the one time I did it, it wasn't pleasant. I lost my way a little bit, and I ended up down in that valley. And down in that valley, it's kind of secluded, a little eerie. And then I went out, and I ended up right next to where my car is. I had to jump a fence to get there. This way is the way up. So there's kind of a Y there, and this is the way up. Behind me is the university. And there's a family coming up behind me, and you just heard a man coming down. This is not too difficult. It's not very much farther to the top. This should be pretty easy climbing. Again, I'm wearing my flip-flops kind of things. And what did I bring with me? Well, I should have brought some water. Didn't. I'll be all right. And I have my metal match in case of any kind of crisis. I have a metal match with me. Shouldn't need it. It's a cloudy day. It might rain. I don't think it's going to rain. The forecast is not for rain. But I did bring my poncho just in case, because I can hide under my poncho if it starts to sprinkle or rain, because my socks, I don't want to get my socks wet. Right up here, now the logging is down below us. We passed all the logging where they're cutting down trees. But they've also cut down a few trees just right here. And here, they've piled up some of the trees. And under here would be a great place to sleep. But there's not a lot of building material to really cover that correctly. I'd have to put my poncho up to protect myself. But this is where I thought, it's right next to the trail. This is where I thought I could sleep some night. I could cover it up some more over the course of a couple of days. Maybe I could put some leaves over the top of it. I really need something solid because the leaves will just fall through. You can see I've kind of put some of the branches up there crisscross to hold up more of the branches. That's where I was thinking of sleeping some night. But with all the brown leaves and just some trees, I don't have really a lot of the materials I feel I need to build it well. And it takes a lot of time, so I kind of said, well, shoot, I'd rather use my poncho than spend days building that debris shelter. Okay, we're almost to the top. Almost there. The family's coming up behind me. Here you can see a couple of benches. I'll start again when we get to the top. Well, I stayed here at the benches. I was going to keep walking, but I decided to let the family pass me. You can see them going up there. Because the other day when I came up here, usually you can't see with all the vegetation and the trees. You can't see anything, hardly. But with all the trees down, with all the leaves off, and it's, you know, definitely winter foliage, through here, there is a little bit of white. Can you see it? Maybe you can't. I was like, is that ice? So a few days ago, I saw that. Nobody was around, and I went off trail. I wasn't wearing my sandals that time. I went off trail, and I went over there, and it is in fact ice. And I said, well, is there a spring? So I followed the ice up to its starting point. And what it is it's like right below a tree, the ground just sinks. And above the tree, it looks like a normal mountain. There's no spring or nothing, but just after this tree, it just sinks. And there is a smidgen of water there. So what I would do, I would go over there and I would go up to that tree, right under that tree where the water's slowly seeping out. And I would dig a hole and fill it with something like a can or some kind of plastic or something. And then I would attempt to fill it with the seepage of the water and then boil it or something. So right over there, there's some sort of spring coming out of the mountain. It's a very slow trickle. The ice there is built up from a long time ago. Maybe it's just rain runoff that's gone through the mountain a little bit and it's seeping out there. But it's not there at the ice. It's just above the ice. Behind the ice, up above the ice there, there's a tree where the water is coming out from under it ever so slowly. It's just a trickle. And you'd have to dig a hole. As I said, I would dig a hole and let the water just ever so slowly fill up the can, and then I would boil it and see and drink that if I had to. Again, the family went up the mountain. I will follow them up there. Well, I've made it to the top. How long has it taken me to get up here? I don't know, maybe 30, 40 minutes. I don't know how long it takes to get up here. I was taking my time, maybe 50 minutes. I'm not sure. Okay, I'll say 45 minutes maybe to get to the top. And what is at the top of this mountain? Well, it's not a very tall mountain by any stretch of the imagination. It's a very quick hike, only 40 minutes or so to slowly hike up it. It's not fast. But actually, there's another 2 hours of hiking behind me, possibly. It's two more hours to the next mountaintop. But this is the mountaintop here. Now, this is the trail down that I came up. There's a couple of benches here. And there's some exercise equipment. And ta-da, a cemetery. This is a cemetery. I look out over the cemetery. I was a little shocked the first time I came up here and found there was a cemetery up here. It's quite large, quite expansive actually. Many pyong goes over on the other mountain hill over there. It's over there. Now here you can see the family in the distance. They're going to hike over here now. Right over there, the road, the trail splits. One goes kind of this way, and it takes a couple of, it's probably 2 or 3 kilometers to the next mountain. And then it also goes the other way, it goes that way. Now, one day, I came up here at night, and it was probably like 7 o'clock or something. And I walked all the way over there, after 7 o'clock, all the way over there, and on the other side of the mountain, and then came back. And it took 3 hours, over 3 hours to get back to my car. Total hiking time was like 3 hours. I started climbing up the mountain like at 6 o'clock or so. I came up about 6, and when I finished going down over there and blah la 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 la, and finally coming back, luckily I had lots of water with me. I was well prepared, and I had a headlamp with me. And it was a really strange adventure. I had never done it before. I had never gone that way during the day. Instead, I went that way at night, and I had never done that, and it was very, very eerie feeling. The strange sounds, the little wind cracking the trees, it was very nervous. And it goes way over there, and it ends up coming down way on the other side of the mountain, actually. It goes on the other side of the mountain, and then you have to come back over the other mountain over here before I came back to the university in my car. So it was a really interesting trek. It's really interesting to do that. I tried doing some headlamp mountain hiking. It's very on a trail you've never been on before, not knowing exactly where you were going. Anyways, I'm gonna go head back down the mountain now, back to my car. Again, it took me 45 minutes to get up here, and let's see how long it takes to get back down. Well, I made it down. It took about a little less than 20 minutes to get down, and so that was my hike. It took about 45 minutes to get up there making the video, and 20 minutes to get down. How's that? The car is here. Time to go home. Have a nice day. Enjoy your hiking.